So good morning, guys. So today we are going to start with the introduction to strategic management. That's your first chapter of strategic management. This is going to be a session full of examples and everything related to business. So I want you guys to be like really interactive with me, okay? So we'll start with the session. Okay. So first, strategic management. Okay, everybody here who's attending the session today wants to become a CA someday, right? You want to become a CA someday. There might be people who want to go into employment. There might be people who want to start their start their practice as a firm. So to be a successful entrepreneur, you need to know SM. Strategic management is something which is really important if you want to become a successful entrepreneur, okay? I'll start with a little bit of history of strategic management. So strategic management as a subject was first introduced in 1911. It was first introduced in 1911. It was introduced in the business school. We call them the B schools. It was first introduced, it was first started in business schools. So that's when, as a subject, strategic management came into place. Okay. So strategic management actually as a subject, it came in 1911. So as a subject, it has been started in 1911, but strategic management has been in our lives forever. Even in our daily lives, it has been there, okay? Suppose you have your exams, you have your May attempt, which is shifted to November, right? So November attempt, for writing November attempt, you guys have to tell me now, how many have made a strategy that by this month I'm going to complete this subject, by this, you need to tell me how many have you have made plans, or you just don't have any plan? Tell me in the comments, do you have any plans like for the next 4 months I'm going to study this, then I'm going to get my revision done with this? Only one person has answered. Who else? I at least need 5 to 10 comments. Yeah, 53 of you are there. Yes, yes, yes. So this plan which you have made, why do you first make a plan? Because you know that in 4 months, something is going to happen which is going to have a huge impact in your life. So to tackle that situation, today you have made a strategy, a plan to read for the next 4 months. This is nothing but just a strategy which you have made. So likewise, the exam which you are going to write is nothing but just an exam. Think of the companies which are just making billions and trillions of dollars every year. And what if they don't move without any strategy? Even if you don't prepare a strategy for your November attempt and just go with the flow, you yourself are going to fail. Think about the big companies and businesses. Won't they fail? Everybody needs to have a strategy. Strategy is very important. Okay. So what we are going to study is what happens in strategic management. Okay, yes. So what happens in strategic management is that the management of the business, what they try to do is they try to predict the future. They try to predict the future and anticipate their future. They try to predict and anticipate their future and they try to develop plans according to it. Example, if there is a company, they will try to predict what is going to happen in the next 10 years. Okay. So in the next 10 years, according to the changes in the environment, they'll prepare a strategy according to that so that they can become a market leader. Okay. So likewise, we'll take an example of fashion industry. Suppose I have been a manufacturer of bell-bottom pants. Okay. Now today I want to, I have been having a manufacturing of bell-bottom pants and I have a store also for that. Do you think the store of bell-bottom pants is going to work today? Definitely not. This person who has a store of bell-bottom pants has not yet predicted the future itself. The trend of bell-bottom pants has just been vanished. Today it's high-waist jeans, it's ripped jeans, it's a pencil fit jeans and everything like that. Okay. So if he's going to run the bell-bottom pants store right now, he's not going to succeed. He's going to definitely fail. Such a business will never succeed. He has not succeeded because he have not anticipated what is going to happen in the future, or he has not predicted what is going to happen in the future. So such businesses, whoever runs a business, need to anticipate the future, make a strategy for the future so they can succeed later. Okay. This is what is written here. So the business policy topic, I'll be taking it in the last. Okay. we'll first start with the concept of management. So we are going to start with the concept of management. So management are management can be classified into two. Okay, one is as people and the other one is process. One is people and then the other one is process. First, we are going to see people. Okay, so in your house, who manages your house? So there must be some kind of a management everywhere. Okay, in your house, who manages your house? Your mom and dad manages your house. If you go in a school, who manages the school? The principal, the chairman, the vice president, whoever is there, they manage the school. Okay. Likewise, if you take a company, who manages the company? Who are the management people in the company? In a company, the CEO, CFO, and all the top level people manage the company. Okay, I hope it's clear till now. So what these people, the CEO and CFO, do is they oversee whatever the work is going on in the business and they prepare long-term strategies for the business. Like they'll prepare strategies where to diversify, where to invest my business in, and all those big strategies, long-term strategies is what this top-level people make. Okay, so this is management in case of people. So in sense of people, the people are the management. So here it's given the key group in an organization. Who is the key group in an organization? The top level people are the key group in an organization and they manage the business. Okay. So what they have said is, what these top level people try to do is, it's given here, what they try to do is they try to make the entity as purposeful and as productive as possible. How do they make the entity purposeful and productive is that, suppose I'll take the example of YouTube, okay? Suppose I'm running a YouTube channel, okay? So for running this YouTube channel, I have 5 to 6 members who are a team. I have 5 to 6 members who are a team, and this team helps me to run my YouTube channel. This team, I can call them as management. Okay. So what these 5 to 6 people do is they try to organize resources. For a YouTube channel, what and all resources would I need? I would need, for any business, you need four kinds of resources. One is the manpower, then it is the money, material, and technology. So what is the manpower I will need? Suppose if while I'm taking class, it's like I need a student always sitting in front of me so that he can ask doubts. So I need that manpower in my YouTube channel. Then what is the next thing is that I will need money. Why will I need the money? Is that I need the money because I want to buy some technology. I want to buy a good camera by which I can record my lectures. Then materials. Materials means all the pen, notebook, and everything. Okay. So what will be included in technology? Suppose if I have made the video, I will need a software to edit the video, right? So all these things, I cannot sit in all the manpower, material, money, and technology. I cannot gather by myself if I have a huge YouTube channel. I need someone else to help. Okay, so there comes these 5 to 6 people who are going to help me integrate these resources. These are all disorganized resources. They'll help me to organize the resources so that I can make my YouTube channel a productive YouTube channel and a purposeful YouTube channel. Okay, so this is what a management is. So what here they say is the survival and success of organization depends on a large extent on the competence and character of its management. So what they try to tell here is, if your organization needs to become the market leader tomorrow and wants to compete against big industries, you will need a very good management or else your business will not survive. Okay, that is what they are trying to tell in the management as people. Okay, up to here. So next, what we are going to see is management as a process. Okay, for this, we will take the example of an event manager. So for this, we are going to take the example of the event manager. So what happens is, suppose we'll take that I have a sister. Okay. So for my sister's marriage, what we have done is we have hired an event manager who is going to look after her reception function, her marriage, and her sangeet. Okay. She is going to look after all the three functions. So what happens here is the manager, who is the event manager, he will see whether all the guests have come, whether all the decorations are made properly, whether the food is being prepared properly according to the safety measures, whether everything is being done on time, whether my guests who have arrived have been allotted their rooms or not, and all those kinds of things the event manager is going to see. So this is nothing but he's managing a lot of functions. Okay. So that is what is told here. This definition we have already read in our 11th and 12th standard, that management, okay, that management is nothing but planning, organizing, directing, staffing and control. So these are the functions that a management may do. So management is also people, a group of people who run the enterprise. Also management may be process and functions like staffing, directing, controlling, planning and organizing and all of that. Okay. So this is what is about management. Next, we are going to move about the concept of strategy. Now, next we are going to move on the concept of strategy. So from here now on, I'm going to give you a lot of examples related to business. So if you have anything which you can relate, please do please do interact with me, okay? So first we are going to start with the concept of strategy. I'm going to read a line from here. Let me see how many of you are able to understand. It is written that the very injection of the idea of strategy into business organization, that means what they are trying to say is, in a business organization, why have they brought the idea of strategy in the first place? Why is something called a strategy has been brought into the business organization? It has brought because it is intended to unravel complexity and reduce the uncertainty which are caused due to the changes in the environment. Okay. So what this means is that, I'll give you an example. So currently the market situation or the current environment of business is highly uncertain. It's just constantly changing every day and every day. Today what happens is that there might be startups which are just starting now and are hitting the billion dollar list, or they might be big companies which are just have a very good market share but are still crashing down. Okay, so for this we can take the example of Jio and Aircel. Okay, so I know Aircel. Yeah, so I guess you guys know what happened with it. Jio was a company. Okay, it when it just started, Aircel and Airtel, these both companies were good market players. They were holding the maximum number of share in the market. Okay, but when Jio came into the business, Jio was just a startup. Jio was just a startup, and it just boomed like so big. Whereas Aircel, which was already a large company, had to crash down. Why this happened? Because Jio had a very, very, very good strategy in place to hold, to get the market share. Whereas Aircel were not able to bring up a strategy to compete with Jio. Whereas if you take the example of Airtel, I'm talking about Airtel. If you take the example of Airtel, Airtel was somehow able to compete with Jio, and today they also have a good market share. Okay. So I hope this line is clear. So why you need strategy is because to reduce uncertainty in the future. Okay, because if Airtel might have already thought that if something like this in the future happens, I must have a strategy towards it. So that only it was able to implement its strategy at the time when the changes actually took place. So the concept of strategy is mainly because the environment we are living is constantly changing. So without a strategy, you will only fail. Okay, so I'll take another example. Okay. So we'll see a few companies which has different kinds of strategies. First, we'll see about Apple. Okay, how many of you are Apple users? Apple users here. Anyone who's an Apple user? None. Okay. So if you take the example of Apple company, Apple company is a company based in America. It's a company which is, it is an American company. Okay. But what happened is, what happened is Apple has production units in different parts of the world. It has a production unit in China and India. We'll take the current situation which is going on. I hope you all are watching some kind of news, and you know that the current tension which is going on between America and China. Do you guys know what's happening right now? What is the war kind of thing which is going between China and America? Do you know? Drop in a S if you know. Nobody. Technology. I'm just saying the thing, yeah, related to technology, all the TikTok ban and that, who is that? I mean, sorry. that the American government is trying to ban the TikTok thing, and all of that is going on right now, right? So the American government has also decided to take away all the production units which are there in China right now. So it has directed its companies that what you have to do is whatever production units or business you have in China, try to take out your business from there and try to put it in different parts of the world. You know what Apple had already... Okay, so what had... So Apple, it had a very good strategy that it had already has forecasted that situations might like this might come in future. So what Apple has done is, Apple also has a production unit in China, and it also has a production unit in India. Majorly it has only in China, but now when this situation has came up, it doesn't need to search everywhere to build up a production unit. It already has a production unit in India in which it can change. So this is a strategy which the Apple had had in place, which helped it to overcome this future event. Okay, next we'll take the example of Google and Microsoft. Okay, we'll take the example of Google and Microsoft. So you know that Google and Microsoft has large databases, has large database in different parts of the world. Okay, they have stored it in different parts of the world. You know what? Microsoft also has a database which it has stored underwater. It is a strategy that Microsoft has stored it in database where? Underwater. Why underwater? Why can't you store it on land? Because what they say is that suppose someday it might happen that earthquake may come and then all my database may get destroyed. So what they have done is they have kept their database underwater. These are the level of strategies that the big companies are thinking of. Okay. So now that we have talked a lot about business, are there any cricket fans here? Are there any cricket fans? We'll talk a little about cricket now. Anyone? Just guys, please be interactive. Okay. Good. So a lot of you. So we'll talk about cricket now. So what happens in cricket is, suppose Team India is going to play a match today. Okay, and Virat is the captain of the team. Okay, suppose cricket, they are going to play a match today, and suppose Virat is the captain of the team. Virat go to the place where they are playing and be like, whatever toss comes, I'll take ball or bat, I'll choose to play batting or bowling, whatever it comes in my mind. Or whether they'll go there and just be like, whatever 11 players I think can play today, I'll let them play. It doesn't happen like that. Not at all. It will not happen like that. Everything, even if it is the most unimportant game, they'll still have a strategy according to the conditions. They will see whether to bowl or bat today according to how the pitch is right now. And also they will see what is the playing level today. According to that, they will decide their 11 players. So even when you play a sport, you will have a strategy which you have to use to succeed. But the question here is, if every time you have a strategy, it is very sure that you will win every time. Is it very sure that if you have very good strategy for a cricket game, will you always win that cricket game? You answer me. Will a strategy, even if it is the best strategy, will it work every time? Yes or no? No. Right. That's right. A strategy is just a guideline. Okay. Strategy is just a guideline that you have kept for yourself. Okay. That anything if Virat would have thought that the opener would make 100 runs, but the opener would have just got out at zero and come back. Okay, so this might also happen. Strategy is not important, that should always work. It is just a guideline so that you are able to reduce the complexity and uncertainty in the environment. Okay, so for that one line, I have given you a lot of example. I hope you would have understood. So you can see here that strategy is a game plan. Okay, what is strategy? Strategy is a game plan which the management of the business uses. Who uses the game plan of strategy? The management of the business uses the game plan of the strategy. Why they use such game plan is they want to take the market position. They want to be the number one leader. They want to conduct their operation. They want to attract a lot of customers so that they can generate revenue. They want to be the best competition to everyone out there. They want to compete successfully. And they want to also achieve whatever the organizational objectives are. Okay. So this is what is strategy. I hope the concept of strategy everybody would have understood. Okay. Are you all clear till now? Is there any doubts? I think the meeting is going to end soon. I'm not sure. Okay. Okay. If anybody is having a difficulty, I'm just telling you again, you can ask me. Okay. You can unmute yourself and ask me. Okay. Next, what we are going to see is here it's written that strategy is consciously considered and flexibly designed scheme of corporate intent. What it tries to say is that a strategy must be flexible. A strategy must be flexible. So example, what you have made a strategy is that in the next 4 months, I have exams. Okay, I have my CA exams. So from tomorrow, I'm going to read every 10 hours a day. I'm going to read 10 hours a day. I know nobody would have planned, but I'm saying, if there is some such sincere student, he might have planned that every day I'm going to read 10 hours a day. But what happens is the next day or the next day, you get sick. Even if you're getting sick and you're not at all able to even get up, how will you study? So the strategy you've made is very good that you should study 10 hours a day so that you can get a rank or something like that. But it must also be flexible that today, if you're not able to study for 10 hours a day, it's okay. Okay, so that is what it is trying to say. Strategy must be flexible according to the changing conditions. Okay, if it is rigid, you'll not be able to follow the strategy properly. Okay. So yes, the next what it is written here, this para right here is very, very, very important. Okay, 85% or 95% of the time this gets tested in the exam, like in one mark and like that. Okay, so it is written here, the strategy is no substitute for sound, alert and responsible management. What it is trying to say is strategy is very important. We understand that. But to implement the strategy, the management is also very important. Even if you have the best strategy in place, and if you don't have a good management, there's no use of such strategy. So strategy cannot be substituted with management. Management has to do its work for the strategy to run. We'll take the example of cricket here, okay? So when today the game has started, you have all the strategy in place. Virat has thought of the best strategy today, but when he gets onto the field, he must give proper direction to his team players also. He must be able to manage them there also. Okay. Strategy doesn't end before the game alone. I mean, doesn't just get plans before the game alone. Even after the game starts, Virat has to manage the team. Okay. So management is important, even if strategy is there. We'll take another example of Ratan Tata, as I've written there. So Ratan Tata has thought this year that he would acquire 5 of the biggest industries and he's going to make like a huge profit this year. What happens is that, but his management is useless. Okay. His management is useless. They are not able to even manage the 5 acquisitions at all. What will happen then? Everything will go in waste. All this money which you have invested will go in waste. So that is what they are trying to say. A strategy is no substitute. It cannot be substituted for sound, alert and responsible management. Okay. That line is very important. Okay. Next, what line is written here? That strategy can never, strategy can never be perfect, flawless and optimal. You can never say that if I have put this strategy, definitely in CA exam, I'm going to get a rank. No way, it's not possible. There might be someone else who would have had a better strategy, or your strategy might have had some kind of error. So the strategy can never be perfect and flawless. Flawless means without any flaws, without any mistake. Okay. So yes, that line is also important. Next, they have written that it must be flexible. I've already told you that. Then what they have told is, in a sound strategy, allowances are made for possible miscalculations and unanticipated events. Okay, once again, yeah. So in a sound strategy, allowances are made for possible miscalculations and unanticipated events. Here, what they are trying to say is, even if you have the best of strategy, 9 out of 10 times the strategy may work. But there will be a chance of 1 out of 10 times that there might be some error in the strategy. So for that error, you need to be flexible. You need to be flexible because there might be some unanticipated event which might happen in the future. Okay. Example, I'll take a few examples here also. Suppose you're playing cricket. Okay. I've started playing cricket. There was no forecast of rain. But suddenly it started raining. This was an unanticipated event. You never knew that this could happen. Okay. Example, we'll take of high polluting industries. Okay, there might be any day when government may just come up and tell that these high polluting industries are very bad for the environment, so we are going to ban the high polluting industries. What will happen in such place? I'll take one more example. We'll take the example of ITC. ITC, Indian Tobacco Company. Okay, so we'll take the example of ITC. I hope ITC is a company which every one of you here must have heard. If you are not, then I don't know. Okay, so ITC started with making cigarettes. ITC started with making cigarettes, okay? You all know that cigarettes is a very, very risky business. Why is it a risky business? Because tomorrow the government may just come up and tell that we are going to increase the tax rate on the cigarettes. So your cigarettes may become costly, okay? Or government may tomorrow come and say that we are going to ban cigarettes. What will happen then? This is when the ITC made a strategy where it knew that something like this could happen in the future. Something like this, it's unanticipated, right? Happen in the future. So what it did was it thought that if something like this happened, definitely we'll have to shut down our business. So what it very intelligently did was it diversified. What it did was it diversified. It now has a range of books. It has a segment for pens. It has a segment for biscuit. It even runs hotels. Okay. So this is how ITC made a sound strategy. Okay, he made allowances that like this may something like this may happen. Okay, some kind of a unanticipated event or a possible miscalculation may happen. So in my sound strategy, I have decided to diversify. Okay, so yes, next we'll have to move on to the next topic. Until now, is everybody clear? So now what next they have written here is, in large organizations, strategies are formulated at corporate, divisional and functional. Actually, about this topic, so there is a separate section which is given, but I'll just give you like a little insight on what the topic is here, okay? So what they say is, in a company, so in a company, there are three levels, okay? There is corporate level, there is divisional level, and there is functional level, okay? So a corporate level consists of the top level management in your business. Divisional level consists of divisional managers and functional level functional managers. We'll take the example of Reliance Industries here. Okay, so Reliance Industries has a lot of different divisions. Okay, so you guys name them. What are the different divisions that Reliance Industries has? It has a petrochemical business. It has Jio. What else does it have? You guys want you to comment down. What kind of segments do Reliance has? There are a lot. It has textile, it has petrochemical, it has Jio, as I told. It has a general store, it has supermarket. Yes. What else? Reliance Fresh. What else? Electricity also, if I'm not wrong. I'm also not really sure about that. Okay. Yeah, it has trends also. It even has a communication range. It has a footwear range and all of that. Okay, so Jio has a lot of business segments. These business segments are nothing but these are the divisions, okay, in which the Reliance Industries has been divided. So there will be a, just look into the drawing right here. Okay, yeah. So what they have here is, you have Reliance Industries. So in total, to manage the Reliance Industries, there will be some top management. There will be some corporate level, okay. They'll have some top management. Then they have different divisions under them, as you all named, okay? To manage each of this division, they will have some divisional manager. So to manage each of these divisions, they will have some divisional manager. So that is the divisional thing. Inside, if suppose we'll take the example of Jio here. So Jio will have a marketing function. So Jio might have a sales function. Jio might have some, what else are there? HR function. So the under Jio, if there are some functions, and if the managers are going to manage these functions, they will be known as the functional managers. So there are three types. Top level managers are known as the corporate level, then you have the divisional level, and then you have the functional level. Functional level managers functional level managers manages the functions. That is like HR, sales, procurement, and marketing, and all of that. Okay. So that is what is written here. We'll see in detail about this, okay, in the later part. We'll move on. Oh, yes. This right here is 99% of the time asked in your exam. This is very, 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 very important. The strategy is partly proactive and partly reactive. This is very important. Okay, guys, note it down somewhere. If you have your books around, if you don't have, just take a screenshot of it so you can mark it later. Okay. So strategy is partly proactive and partly reactive. What is partly proactive and partly reactive means here? So partly proactive means that I am going to anticipate my future. I am going to predict my future and I'm going to plan for it now itself. Okay, like where was I? I was at, yeah, proactive strategies. I told you that proactive strategies means you're going to anticipate your future and predict your future and you're going to plan for it now itself. Example is ITC. Example is, sorry, I was giving another example. I just forgot what it was. Okay, we'll go on with, okay, yeah, I was giving about Apple. So Apple, you know that it anticipated the future that someday it might happen that China and America might have like a tension between them. So they anticipated a future and had production units in different parts of the world. Likewise, ITC also anticipated the future. ITC also predicted the future that predicted the future that there might be some kind of a ban on the sugar business. Okay, so then what it did was bring about strategies by anticipating the futures and it diversified. So this is what is proactive strategy. Now what we are going to see is what is reactive strategy. Okay. So reactive strategy is where something has already happened. Due to which you have changed the strategy now. So what this tells is that, suppose we'll take the example of Google Meet, okay? Someone sent me a link of Google Meet yesterday telling me that why don't you take in there the lectures, okay? So when I went and researched about it, it actually said that it was actually first working on money. You had to pay to use the Google Meet. But now what it has happened is it has seen that there is a change in the environment today. Today everybody is going to need online platforms like these two. Work for their business. So what it did was it created a strategy. What Google Meet did was is till September, okay, till this year, September, it is going to give the Google Meet for free. After that, it is starting to charge because it can gain a lot of customers right now if it is going to give for free. So by giving it for free, what it is going to do is it's going to attract a lot of customers today. So that when it even charges, if the quality is very good of the app, everybody is going to still pay for it and use it. So this is the reactive strategy which Google adapted, okay? Because of the change in the environment, because of the pandemic today, it changed its strategy and same like Jio. It changed its strategy and adapted itself, okay? So this is what is partly proactive and partly reactive. So whenever you make a strategy, you can't be always proactive. That means always you cannot anticipate the future. Likewise, you can't be always reactive. You will not plan anything on the day of accounts exam, only I'll read for exam. You cannot be like that. Okay, you cannot always be reactive. So it is always a blend of both. Remember this word very well. It is a blend of both. Your strategy is a blend of both. Okay. So it's written here. You can see. Yes. So what it is written here is proactive actions on the part of managers to improve company's market position and financial performance. So in the future, if the company wants to have a good market position and be the market leader and even improve its revenue and all of that, it has to have proactive strategies. What is reactive strategies? Reactive strategies means some unanticipated events may happen or some fresh market conditions means you'll get a new market, like how Google Meet got a new market today. So like that it may happen. So according to that, you have to do reactive strategies. So that is what is said in the next para also. Company uses both reactive and proactive strategies and all of that. Then down it is given here that, yeah, what here it is given is that your proactive and reactive strategy, that your strategy is always not freshly decided. Suppose in this year, if you are going to have a strategy, it does not mean that every year you will have to build a new strategy. What may happen is for the past 5 years, you might have had a strategy, okay? and that might have would have worked really well for you, really well for the company. So what you will do is you will just try to take the same strategy and work on it now also, and with just a little modifications according to the environment. So strategy is not always freshly derived. It can also be taken from the from the previous strategies if it worked well. If it worked well, okay, that is what is written here. You can give it a read once the session gets over. Please take your books and give it a read. Okay. Yeah. So next, what it is written here is, so next what they have said here is, not every strategic move is the result of proactive planning and deliberate management. An unanticipated event might happen, so you have to take a strategic reaction. So strategic reaction is known as reactive strategy. All of the same thing they have told here. Okay. One second, guys. I'll see. Okay. So I'll just give you another example here. Okay, so you guys understand better. How many of you have used the Nokia mobile phones? How many of you have used Nokia mobile phones? Anybody here who have used? Anyone else? So a lot of you have used Nokia phones. Okay. So what happened is, I use those tones. Okay. So what happened is that Nokia suddenly shut down one day. Why? No. So what we are going to see is that what happened actually with Nokia. Okay. So what happened was, Nokia was running great. It had 90% of the market share when it was a market leader. 90% of the market share, guys. But what happened was, one day Android, a software called Android, came and the Android manufacturers, Android. So Android, it went to the mobile manufacturers. What it Android went and told is that, please use my software. Okay, Android went to all the mobile manufacturers and said, please use my software. What Nokia did was, it was a market leader. Okay, it can say whatever it wants. It said that, no, I'll not use. I'll only use the Microsoft software. So it denied the Android software. It only used Microsoft software. What happened then was, his business just shut down immediately. Okay, and at that time itself, Samsung and iPhone took Nokia over. Okay, they started becoming the market leaders. What happened was, other companies also saw it. All the small mobile manufacturing companies also saw it. Where Samsung had started using Android feature, whereas Nokia was using the Microsoft software. So the other companies saw that Nokia on a Microsoft software or a platform was a big failure, whereas Samsung on the Android platform was a huge success. Okay, at that time Samsung was nothing. Okay, when the Nokia's period was going on, but suddenly it took over the market. Okay, so what other companies did is, well, they also thought like that something like this is being going on, so we'll also take the Android software itself. Okay, so this was an unforeseen development. Nobody thought that Nokia, a company like that, would shut down suddenly, but it had. So you should not be rigid like Nokia. Okay, you must be able to adapt to the changing conditions. You must be able to the environment right now, okay, and all the market conditions. Then only you'll be able to succeed, or else you'll not be able to. Okay. Okay, that and all is what is given here. Now we'll see the topic of strategic management. So what it says is, so what is strategic management? I'll first tell you. So strategic management is the big circle in which strategy is a small circle. Strategic management is a big circle in which strategy is a small circle. So it is, strategic management is a broad term. Okay, it's a broad term where, in which strategy planning is also planned. Okay, so why do we do, what is strategic management? First I'll tell you that so that you're able to understand this. Okay. Here it is written. I hope. Okay. So what it is said here is that strategic management is a process. Okay, strategic management is a process where you first, what you do is, if you're going to start a company right now, you will first set up a vision for the company. Suppose I am starting a YouTube channel, and the vision for my company is that I want to provide free education to all. So I'll set up a few objectives related to that. Okay. And then to make this YouTube channel a success, I'll create some kind of a strategy. The strategy might be that I'll do my videos in English so it is able to reach everybody. Everybody is able to get benefit out of it and all that. After that, I will just thinking or just crafting a strategy that I'll put my videos in English. It's not enough. You have to also implement. You have to first put the video so that the business runs. Okay. So then I'll implement my strategy. After implementing, I will evaluate. If I have an American accent, nobody will be able to understand. So suppose I have an American accent, then I will evaluate why people are not able to understand, because they need an Indian accent. Okay. So then I will try to evaluate my strategy and I'll take corrective adjustment. That means I will try to change my accent. So this is what happens in a strategic management. The strategy is just a part. When all these things, strategic vision, setting objectives, crafting a strategy, implementing, evaluating, corrective action are all a part. That's why I told you strategic management is a big circle, whereas strategy is a small circle in that. Okay. I hope you have understood this. Okay. Yeah. So why is strategic, why are all these needed? Why is strategic management, what are the objectives of strategic management is written here. There are two objectives why you bring in the strategic management. First is to create a competitive advantage. That means you want to be the best competitor out in the market. You want to outperform everybody. You want to have dominance in the market. That is why you have strategic management. That is one objective. The second objective is that you want to guide the company successfully through all the changes in the environment. So if suppose tomorrow or today some changes come, you want that your company doesn't shut down. It just glides beautifully over all the changes and just makes itself a success. So these are the two objectives of strategic management. This also may come in the exam, okay? We have seen this. 1 second. Give me a minute. Okay, next what you are going to see is the importance of strategic management. This is also a very important topic, okay? That's why I put in a star there. After the proactive and reactive, this is the next important one. Okay. Okay, until this everybody is clear. Until this everyone clear. Nobody has any doubts. Okay, so we are going to see importance of strategic management. Why is strategic management important? Okay, what they have written here, read this line very carefully. It's a very good line. Okay, it's written that survival of the fittest is the principle. Okay, it was propagated by a scientist named Darwin. Okay, so survival of the fittest is the only principle of survival of organization. Okay, where the fittest are not the largest and strongest organization, but those who can actually change and adapt to the changes in the business environment. What we're trying to say here is, who do you think will survive in the future years? The people who are the largest will not survive, or the strongest are not going to survive. Always remember this, the strongest and largest organization is not important that they survive. But even if it is a small organization and it is ready to adapt to the changes, whatever I've been throwing upon it, then it will be able to survive. One of the best example can be Google. I'll give a few examples for these also, okay? So first, I'll take the example of Nokia and Samsung. Samsung was a very small company, whereas the Nokia was the largest and strongest company. But Nokia was not able to survive, but the Samsung, which was a tiny company, which was able to adapt to the changes, survived. And today it has a big market share. That is one example, Nokia and Samsung. Next, we'll take the example of Orkut and Facebook. So Orkut is a social media network by Google. Okay. So what happened was, when we were young, I think we were around 8-9 years old maybe. That time Orkut was a big hit. Okay. Everybody was using Orkut. But what happened is, after a few years, Facebook started taking over it. What happened actually was that Orkut after a period of time, it just stopped changing. It didn't bring in any new feature in Orkut itself, okay? But whereas Facebook, what it did was, it was just a startup that time. Okay, what it did was, it started having changes every 2 to 3 years. What it did was, suddenly it added a news feed, it added a chat box, the DP, which was square before it changed to circle, it added a story. Something like that, it kept on adding so that users were able to have the freshness, whereas Orkut just got on boring and boring after years and years of use. So this is one example. Also, I'll take an example of Amazon. So right now, Amazon, before this pandemic even started, Amazon had were researching on drone delivery. Okay, so it already is a big market player, but still it wants to adapt and change. It wants to have drone delivery possible. It wants to have less human interaction. Okay, it wants to just simplify the delivery process. Okay, so Amazon is working on drone deliveries right now. So it is even the largest and strongest, but it's not just sitting like, okay, I'm the strongest and largest, I'll survive. No. It's still trying to be the fittest of the all. It's still trying to change, okay, according to the changes in the environment. Okay. Then I hope this is clear. Now we are going to move on to benefits only. We have last, how many topics should we have left? We have the benefits, we have limitations, we have levels of organization, and we have non-profit organization. So we'll quickly try to complete this in the next 10 minutes. So for the benefits and the limitation, if you just study, you'll be able to understand. I'm going to tell you a story by which you're able to memorize. I'm not going to make you understand this. So these many examples I have given you, even if you read it, you'll be able to understand. I'm just going to give you an example so you can understand. Now we are going to, okay. So I hope many of you would have had boyfriends or girlfriends in their past life, okay? Or you might have now, lucky if you are, okay? So we'll try to study benefits. Okay. So we'll take the example of boyfriend and girlfriend here. Okay. So what happens is that, and I'll just tell you the story first. Listen to the story point by point. I'm going to tell you. Okay. So first, what they say is not at all for CS students. There might be some in the lot. You never know. Okay. So first, what happens is that you want to. Okay. Okay, guys. So what happens is that now you have completed your CA degree. You have completed your 12th standard, suppose. Okay, you have completed your 12th standard, suppose. And now your life goal is you just want to be happy in your life. And what you think is, if I have a partner or a boyfriend or a girlfriend in my life, I will be happy. I just want to get married and just settle down in my life. So first is that... First point is that it gives a direction to the company to move ahead. So you are the company. So now you have a direction that in your life you want to get married. That is your direction. Okay. And it is also a realistic objective. I hope everybody wants to get married and they can get married. Okay. So first point is that it gives you a direction where you want to go in life. Okay. Risky business. Okay. What happens is that you want to be proactive instead of reactive. You want to be proactive. You don't want to arrange marriage in your life. You want it to be a love marriage. Okay, you want it to be a love marriage. You don't want it to be an arranged marriage. So you are being proactive. Now itself you are deciding what kind of a partner you want, this and all that. And you don't want like your parents showing your partner, then you are choosing. You choose for yourself. So you are being proactive instead of reactive here. Okay, sorry guys. So what you do is, now itself you're being proactive and you start finding for a new love in your life. Okay, suppose we'll take the example here of a boy who is searching for a girl right now. Okay, so you are searching for a girl, you're searching for a love. What happens is that, so what you do is, suddenly one day what happens is, when you're walking on the road, you see this beautiful girl over there and you try to talk to her, but you're not able to talk. Then by some research fellows you have called your friends, they research about the girl and tell you that she is also 12th pass right now, and she is going to study CA. What she's going to do? She's going to study CA. You poor fellow, you have completed 12th right now. You don't want anything, but you just want a love life. But you have no other go but to study CA right now. So you also, what you do is, you take a major decision in your life that you are going to study CA for only to marry that girl. Okay, then only you'll be able to spend more time with that girl, right? So that is what is written here. Framework provides framework for all major decisions. You had a major decision to what to do after 12th. But finally, when you know that the girl is going to do CA, you also went into CA. Okay, it provided you a better guidance on what to do next. Okay. So now that you have joined CA and all of that, What happens is you have started becoming friends right now, okay? And you are there to propose the girl. You're there to propose the girl. Okay. Now you don't know what is going to happen. Okay. You are not sure what is going to happen. You just have to accept whatever happens. If you're going to propose, if she's not going to accept, also you have to accept it. And if she is going to accept your proposal, also that situation also you have to accept. Okay. So you are preparing yourself to face the future right now. Whatever the future might be, you're preparing yourself to face the future. Okay, that's the next point. Okay, so what happens is that. Okay, so what happens is that, and like a very nice love story, the girl also accepts it. The girl also accepts it. So you have like got a very good future right now. Okay. But what may happen? But what happens is you already had a girlfriend when you were young. Okay, you already had a girlfriend, and the girlfriend was like very. She used to always spend your money. Okay, but this time the girlfriend which you got does not spend your money at all. She's like will share in everything and all of that. So what have happened? This is a mistake or pitfall. It might be a pitfall in which you could have fallen into. Again, the same spending of money, again crying to parents for money and asking for pocket money and all of that. But this time, this didn't happen. You have avoided a lot of costly mistake this time. Okay, so this is avoiding a costly mistake, which is awesome. So what happens is because of this, you have a beautiful love life all over. You always needed a girl like her. Okay, so this enhances the longevity of the business. This enhances the longevity of your love life. Okay. Then what finally happens is that finally, what was your goal at the start? You wanted to marry her. But what happens is that her parents are not accepting right now at all. They're not accepting right now. This is what happens here is that you are facing a lot of competencies and everything. But then you still want to marry her. So you fight for your survival and growth of the love life. Okay. So I hope this story is clear to everybody. This is how you have to remember this. If you need the story, I'll put this story again in the, I'll send it in the Telegram group. Okay, so you are able to revise it again. Okay, is everything understood here? Is the benefits okay right now? Will you be able to remember? Okay. Why only two replies? Fast, fast, fast. We don't have much time. Okay, cool. And all everybody will remember properly. Other things you remember or not. Okay. Next is limitation. Okay, next is limitation. Limitations, we are going to talk about your ex. Who are we going to talk about? We are going to talk about your ex here. Because if she is a benefit, then your ex must be a limitation, obviously. What did I tell you? How was your ex? I told you that your ex-girlfriend was someone who used to always spend your money and torture you like anything. Okay. So what it was is she was very costly and she was very difficult to understand also, and she was very time consuming also. So she was very costly, she was difficult to understand, and she was also time consuming. That are also the three features of limitation. Okay. So the environment here you can see. It's difficult to understand. I'll just show you. Here it's written, see. It's difficult to understand. Okay. And it is also a time consuming process and also a costly process. Okay. And I'll just tell you in business wise also what this actually means. So for remembering, I told you about ex-girlfriend. So time consuming process means, why is business actually a time consuming process? Because now we'll get into a study mode. Okay, get back to your study mode. Yes. So why is it a time consuming process? Because a strategy for, if suppose Apple, if there is Apple, okay, can you and I sit and put a strategy for Apple and give them? We are not able to even prepare a good strategy for exam. What strategy will we prepare to the big companies and give? We will not be able to do that, okay? So what happens here is that, so experts will be needed. That's why it's first a costly process. So the example I give you was a costly process because you have to hire experts. You and I can't sit and build a process for a big companies like Google and Apple. They're not even accept, okay? So we'll need experts for it. Why is it a time-consuming process? Because for preparing a strategy for 4 months exam, next 4 months, one single exam, you take minimum 2 to 3 hours time to prepare a strategy for just 8 subjects. That itself, again and again, you prepare. Okay, it is a time-consuming process. For this itself, you take 2 hours to prepare a strategy. But think of the $50-60 billion companies who have to prepare their strategies. how much of a time it would take. It even takes weeks and weeks, months and months, and even a few companies take a year to prepare strategies. So it is also time consuming and a costly process. Plus, the environment is also difficult to understand. It's just very complex. You don't know what is going to happen next. So preparing a strategy is difficult. Okay. And the last point and limitation is that it is difficult to clearly estimate the competitive responses to a firm's strategies. So what happens is that you create a strategy. And here we take the example of Jio and Airtel. We'll take the example of Jio and Airtel. So what happened is that Jio brought in an amazing strategy when it entered into the market as a startup. Okay, so it had a good strategy, but Jio never knew that Airtel could be a competition to them. It still is a competition to Jio right now. So you never know, even if you're going to bring a good strategy, the other firm, what the other strategies they might bring. Okay, so the other firms may also bring the strategies to you that you will not be able to ever know. So that is also a limitation when you create a strategy. Okay, so benefits and limitations, I hope it is clear. If it's clear, just send in a message, send in a thumbs up or whatever you can. We just have two more topics left. I think I'll be able to cover it in the next half an hour. I still wonder. Sorry, the message went off. Okay, guys. So last two topics, just half an hour, we are going to just finish it. Okay. So first is, just get a little serious in this alone. This might be a little difficult for everybody. I don't know why people find it difficult. It's easy only. The strategic levels in organizations. So there are totally three levels, as I already told you, right? In the Jio example, corporate level, business level, and functional level. Suppose if the head office is Reliance, that means it is the cooperative level. The division would be Jio, trends and all that. And under Jio, you will have a different kind of functions, which is production function, market function, sales function, and all that. So corporate level, who manages is the CEO, board of directors, and other people. Business level, the divisional managers and staff. In functional level, the functional managers manage it. Okay, sorry. So now we are going to see about all of the three levels, okay? So before we move into that, here I wanted to tell you that you have this business level, right? What is this business level? This business level is nothing but the divisional level, which I told you. Divisional level, which I told you. Okay. A divisional level means a person who will manage you will be a manager of division. So business level managers or division. These divisional level or business level has another name, which is known as divisional level. Divisional level has another name, which is known as strategic business units. It is known as SBUs. Always remember, business level, this is the second level. The business level or divisional level can also be known as strategic business units, which is written here. So don't get confused. What is a strategic business unit? Okay. So it is also known as strategic business units. Okay. Yeah. First, now we'll see the corporate level management. In corporate level management, what does the corporate level management do? This management does not specifically make strategies for Jio, does not make strategies specifically for trends or Reliance Fresh or anything like that. It makes strategies as a group as a whole. Overseeing all the whole organization, it makes some strategies, okay? Not for a specific division, but for the organization as a whole, it makes some strategies, okay? So what kind of strategies they may make is where to invest in, where to diversify in, or where to do, where to venture into right now, where can we get the best resources right now, what will be our strategies for the future, and how are we going to be the market leader? And what else? How are we going to attain our vision and mission? All these the corporate level management or corporate level managers see. Here there is given an example of Godrej. Okay, here there is an example of Godrej here. You can look into it afterwards. Okay, after I finish the session, go and read the Godrej example. Sorry, guys. So, yes. So what it is said here is that it is, now we saw about corporate level management. What they say is corporate level management, it is the responsibility of the corporate level management that they try to give the best out of the business for their owners. That they try to give the best for their owners. The owners are the shareholders. That means if you want to give the best to the shareholders, you have to give the maximum wealth to the shareholders. So that is what they mean. The corporate level management tries to maximize the shareholders' wealth. Okay, this point can also be asked in exam. Okay, so that is about corporate level management. We are going to see about the, we have seen the corporate level, we are going to see about the second level management. In the second level management, they say that, in the second level manager, it includes business level manager. It includes business level manager or divisional level managers. What these business level managers or divisional level managers is, suppose I am the divisional level manager, I'm the division manager for, let's suppose, Jio. Okay, I'm the division manager for Jio. What I'll do is, the company as a whole will make a, the corporate level management will make a strategy. Suppose the strategy of corporate level management is that this year we must at least increase our profits by 10%. We must increase our profit by 10% this year. What a business level manager or a division level manager will do is, what as a manager of Jio I will do is, I will see what and all marketing strategies I can bring to increase the 10% profit in my, someone has unmuted themselves. Okay. So as a manager of Jio, what I see is, what I can do, what kind of sales strategies or marketing strategies I can bring that will help my company to achieve the 10% profit. So the corporate level will just say that all the divisions help me in achieving my 10% profit objective. The divisions are the people who will make strategies for their own divisions. Each division will make a strategy for themselves that how they are going to help in attaining the corporate level strategy, which is to increase the 10% profit. I may make some marketing strategies or something like that. Okay, that is what is written here. The third one is functional level managers. Functional level managers means, if so now I have told, I have told that marketing division and sales division, you two guys are only going to help me attaining this 10% profit. So the managers who are responsible for the marketing department and sales department are the functional level managers. So suppose there is a, we'll now get into the third step. So first we saw corporate level, then we came into Jio. Now what we are going to see is the functional level, the marketing level we have come. So now think yourself as a marketing level manager. Okay, suppose now we are the functional level manager. I am the marketing manager for Jio. Now I will see, what kind of strategies can I bring into place? Because I am the one who is going to directly work with the customers right now. Okay. So now I'm going to, I just got an example right now in the mind. Okay, we'll take this example. Okay, suppose this 10% strategy was a strategy for some kind of a cafe. And if you would have, if anybody is from Chennai, I suppose, you have these malls, this Phoenix Mall and Express Avenue malls and all malls like that. In those malls, though, there is a store. I don't remember the name exactly. It's not striking my mind. It's some kind of a cafe or a, something, I think, cream and fudge or something like that. What they do is, when they run the whole, when they run their business, no, in the, if they have a shop in the mall, what they do is they start dancing suddenly. When the customers, there is a huge crowd around them. No, what they do is, to attract customers towards the cafe, what they do is they start dancing suddenly. And it's very quite attractive. You know, when I was even walking past the shop, okay, walking past the store, I didn't even notice the store which was there. Suddenly, they started dancing and everybody of us went, got attracted to the store, and we even got a few products from the store. Okay, so these are the kind of strategies that you can do to market your products. So functional level manager, so that store's functional level manager would have thought that like this will have a dance performance so that everybody is getting attracted. Okay, so he might have thought something like that. That's why he is the most close to customers, right? He will know how the customers will get attracted. Does anyone know the store's name? I mean, some kind of cafe or something. I don't know. Okay. So, yes. So, here, read this point. I'll just mark here. Okay, what they say is, functional level managers provide the most important information. Why? Because they are the one who are working the closest to the customers. So, you know what? What the even the corporate level management are not able to think of strategies, these functional level managers will be able to think, because they are the one who knows the customers very well rather than the corporate level management. So sometimes even the person from functional level manager may give good ideas. I'll tell you this. You know what? Google. Okay, I hope everybody's heard of Google. You know, I'm not sure whether it is Google. I think it is Google. I read it on their platform only. So you know what happens is every year Google has a summit kind of thing. Okay, what happens in that program is that everybody in the company who is working for Google in the company, what they do is everybody will think of a strategy or a plan on how Google can do better. Even the people who work there, even the maid, even the servant, even the watchman, even the peon boy, from the highest level of managers to the lowest level of people who are working on ground, they are told to put in their strategy on how Google can improve. This is how you get the best. You know what? Even Google got a strategy from a watchman. That is what I heard. I'm not sure. And they implemented it, and it even became a big success. You never know who can come up with a good idea. So that is what is. I just got another example. But if I'm going to give you a lot of examples now, we are already running late on time. After I finish this session, if I'm able to, I'll give you even more examples. Okay. Okay. Yes. So we are done with the levels of management. Okay. We are moving towards the end. I hope to finish it. If it even takes 5 more minutes, just stay on. Okay. Yes. What do you think? There are like different kind of organizations. Okay? There are organizations who work for profit motive. There might be organizations which are working for non-profit motive. There might be organizations which are working for non-profit motive. So what may happen is that the organization, suppose let's just say for example, okay, this YouTube channel is my organization. I am working for a non-profit basis only, okay? So if I'm working for a non-profit basis, that means, sorry, once again. Yeah, sorry guys. Okay. So does that mean that I'll not need a strategy to run my YouTube channel? Does that mean that I won't need a strategy at all if I'm a non-profit organization? If I don't have a strategy on what I'm going to post today or tomorrow, or what is a plan for the next 1 week, even my YouTube channel will just get shut down. Even if you're profit or non-profit making, you definitely need to have strategy. So remember this one. Okay. So now we are going to see about three non-profit organizations. I guess one is educational institution, one is about the medical institutions, and another one is about the government organization. So about how these three non-profit organizations use strategy is what we are going to see. The first is educational institutions. Educational institution, you know this question right now. I don't know how many of you read and went to the exam. This question was a November 2019 attempt SM question. This came for 5 marks in the exam. Educational institution. Talk about educational institution. Now when I'm going to tell you what is there in the content, you'll be like, is this the question that I left and came in the exam? See, now I'll tell you what is there, okay? What is the content? So what they say is educational institutions, what they assume here is that all the education maximum works on non-profit basis, but that is not the truth, we all know. Okay. So what they are trying to say is that in educational institutions, you need to have strategies. Why do you need to have strategies in educational institutions? Because you need to attract the best of students you can. For attracting a lot of students, you need to have the best of strategies in place. Okay. So we'll take the example. Okay. So here what I'll read this line and take the example. So what here they have written is the educational delivery system. How you deliver your education. That means before this pandemic, everyone were, or not actually the pandemic, before a year, most of them were delivering it through, what do you say, pen drives. Still in Tamil Nadu, there is a huge, a huge market only for offline business. I don't know why, but you see, if you see the northern parts of India, no, there in the CA business, everybody has gone online. You mostly only have pen drive classes which are working, or you have virtual classes and all of that. Okay, so educational delivery system has been totally changed right now, okay, due to the introduction of computers and internet technology. Because you have an advantage in pen drive. If I'm uploading something on YouTube, it's an advantage to you guys because you can watch it anytime, anywhere. Okay. So rather than I'm taking this in person, it's better that I can take it on net. Okay. So like this educational delivery system has also gone a lot of changes. So what is happening in this? Sorry, I just forgot about the example. So I told you I'll take example of Byju's. So I know maximum everyone would have heard of Byju's. Shah Rukh Khan comes in the ad. Okay. So Byju's is a company, you can say, that just turned upside down the whole business of education. Okay, the whole business of higher education in our system. Okay, So yes, that is a good example. It became a threat to a lot of fusion centers. Many people started moving on to Byju's. Okay. So then next what they are told is that online degrees are becoming more common today. Okay. Now in this pandemic, everybody is searching, what is the next online degree can I do? Can I do MD, MBA in my on the net and all of that like that. Okay. So just being a threat to the traditional colleges. Yeah, they spend a lot of money on marketing also, right? Okay. So they are so what? Yeah. So they are becoming threat to traditional colleges. So if suppose we take the example of any college, I hope some of you might be going to the college right now. What happens if your college suddenly says that we'll not be able to take online classes anymore? Just leave and go. If every one of you leave and go, we'll just get shut down the college. The college needs to adapt to the pandemic, which is going on right now. It needs to get online. Okay, so this is the adaptations that education institution, the strategies that education institution uses to attract customers and be the market leader. This is what they asked for 5 marks, guys. You tell me in the chat box, will you not be able to write this for 5 marks and come? You just need to write the same thing. You can also even write story ideas in this and come. Will you be able to write this for 5 marks or not? If this comes in exam, the next attempt is what I mean. Yes or no? You better write, okay? If you don't, then I don't know why have you even come to write and study CA. Very simple. Okay, so now you will understand how strategic management is very simple as compared to EIS. It is just that, one, you're not taught properly. Or second, but ICA expect us to copy and paste the material. Not at all. In the end, if some of you want, I'll tell you how I scored in my strategic management. Okay. So yes, we'll just complete it. Next is medical institutions. So medical institutions, one second, guys, what is the time right now? 11:20. Yes. So medical institutions. So in medical institutions means the hospital. What kind of strategies? They are also considered non-profit organization. I have no idea why are they even considered as NGOs, right? NGOs right now. Okay. So hospitals. So hospitals, what kind of strategies they are bringing is, rather than the patient going to the hospital, the hospitals are coming to the patient. Okay, the hospitals are coming to the patient right now. They are ready to come to your doorstep and collect door-to-door samples and all of that. Okay, example is, you can take example of Medlife. I'm not sure how many of you have heard about it. Yes. So Medlife, 1 month ago, it had a scheme where, you know, please mute yourself. Okay. So it had a scheme, you know, where they told that they'll come to our home and they'll only charge for what they are going to. They'll only charge for, they only are going to charge for the testing. If they are going to come home, take the test and go, for that transportation cost they might incur, no, that for that they are not going to charge at all. So free. So for free, of course, they are going to come to home and take your samples and go. And the report will be generated within 2 days and you'll get your report. So these are the kind of strategies that medical organizations are making today. There are even apps for consultancy online, right? So today you even have doctors. So that is very helpful. See, these apps, the app owners right now, so I'll tell you first what the app is. The app works so easy, just started, sorry. So yes, the app works is that you just have to take an appointment with the doctor online and he's going to have a checkup with you online itself, and whatever problems you have to tell it to the doctor and he will give you a prescription. What an amazing idea. You just don't even have to step out of your home. See, there might be, the app owner, no, this app actually came before the pandemic itself. So the app owner might have thought, he might have anticipated the future that something like this may come, or it might be easier for the users to be at home and get their appointments done rather than sitting in queues for hours and hours. So this is the level the medical organizations are thinking. I don't know the app name right now. Yes. Okay. So what they are doing is they're even doing backward integration strategy. So what is backward integration? Forward integration is going to come in later chapters. I'll tell you that when we later move on to the chapter. Okay. So what they're doing is, first, how it used to happen is that the hospital used to run separately. Ambulance services used to run separately. Then they had waste disposal services. The waste which is collected from the hospital will be disposed. No, for that they had some service providers separately. Now what had happened is, this hospital is trying to even give the ambulance services. It is also trying to dispose its own waste by itself. So these are the kind of strategies this is doing so that it can get a good market share. Okay. Next is the last topic, guys. Next is the governmental agencies and department. Next is the governmental agencies and department. Forward and backward diversification. What did I do? Integration. You can also say that as integration. Okay. Skip this. Okay. Government. So government also needs strategies. Okay. So we are the people who are paying tax to them, right? Okay. So we are paying our money, which we are paying our hard-earned money to the government. So government must have a good strategy and how they are going to use the taxpayers' money. So that is where they can use a strategy. But here, backlash is that government agencies are not having as many strategies as the private players have right now. Okay, that is what is told. Nothing much to talk about it. Oh, yes, I had business policy. Thanks for reminding. Yeah. Okay. So now that you have understood strategy, I'll tell you what is business policy. I'm telling you what is business policy. Okay. So strategy is something which is always related to long term. Whereas business policy means short term. That is nothing. This is the difference. Okay. Strategy is long term, whereas business policy is short term. I'll give you an example for this also. Now, suppose you are in a football ground, okay? You have two goal posts, okay? You have two football, goal posts where you have to score the goal. And you have players here, So, my long-term strategy is that I want to score a goal. What is my long-term strategy? To score a goal. Not long-term strategy. Strategy means long-term only. So, my strategy is to score a goal. Why is this strategy? Because I want to win the match. To win the match, I have a strategy that I should score the goal. How am I going to score the goal? From one player to another player, I'll pass. From another player to another player, I'll pass. From another player to another player, I'll pass. And this, he will finally kick in the goal. Okay. So this passing is there. No, the small passing. This is nothing but business policy. These are the small steps you take to achieve your strategy. Or to achieve your strategy, is that right? Yes. To just succeed in your strategy so that you can succeed in your goal. So business policies are short term, whereas strategy is long term. Is this example clear? Or I should just explain it once. This is what is business policy. That's it. Hey guys, thank you. Have a good day. Bye-bye. Also, don't forget to study the chapter once today itself. Okay, once it's done. Bye.